Yo, what up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We just had the official Vanguard multiplayer reveal a few hours ago, and there's a lot of mixed emotions in the community. People who are extremely happy about what they saw, people who are upset over what they saw, some people who are kind of in the middle, and that is totally okay. I implore each and every one of you to explore and play the beta at your own pace, send feedback to the team at Sledgehammer as you see fit, and of course, just have fun. First and foremost, that's the most important thing. Have fun. And I think that with how everything is set up for the beta, there's many different ways to do so. But in this video today, we're going to be talking about some brand new information that was just given to us through the multiplayer reveal. This is information that wasn't even told to those of us that were playing the beta early. And much of this information came as a genuine surprise, which made me smile ear to ear. So let's start with the first piece of information that we got today. And that is clans are returning. They're coming in the form of regiments, except it's going to be renamed for Vanguard. They're simply going to be called groups. Very similar to Modern Warfare, once you invite someone to your group, they can get access to like a happy hour, which is like 1 hour of double XP. You can also get extra XP if you party up with teammates. I'm assuming that's going to be coming back as well. But outside of that, there is going to be a progression system for each and every individual clan, which is going to be great. You can have your own unique emblem for the clan as well. And while you're playing, you can earn battle pass related rewards for each and every person in the group, which is fantastic. So nobody's going to be left behind. If somebody maybe can't jump on and play and you're able to play with your friends, you'll actually be helping somebody else while they're at work or school or whatever earn stuff on their battle pass. At least that's the vibe I'm getting from what they've explained. And I think that's pretty dang cool. I think that this battle pass reward system that they're talking about is actually going to be a separate battle pass system outside of the normal one that we find every single season. But then again, we don't have much information on this as of right now, other than knowing that we'll be able to work together in a clan, in a group, and be able to earn more rewards, which is fantastic. So another thing that was revealed through this stream was operator leveling and weapon favorites. Operator leveling is making a return, and for those of you that are unfamiliar with how this works, just think back to like, I don't know, hero gear. Remember that? Back during BO3, we could earn like different types of gear sets for completing challenges and using a specific operator. That's kind of the same idea here. By using an operator, you can unlock new cosmetics, whether that's skins or calling cards. You can even get finishing moves and more just by playing the matches with a specific operator. On top of that, to take it a step further, they mentioned that there are no longer any factions, at least in this particular game. Instead of it being like Axis versus Allies, it's going to be Team A and Team B. So that means whatever operator you pick, you're going to play as that operator in game. This is going to cause quite a bit of confusion, I'm sure. They're going to have to try to do something to differentiate some of these characters from the other ones on the enemy team. From what I experienced in the beta, though, it was pretty easy to tell apart different characters, even though we all kind of looked the same, right? But I'm hoping that there's even more identifiers to let us know which character belongs to which team. We've had games in the past where factions didn't exist, so think about Infinite Warfare or BO3 or 4, where you could play as the same specialist. Someone on the enemy team could be playing as Battery while you play as Battery, and the only difference identifying factor is that Battery's armor had like red LED lights on it as to where your teammate's armor had blue LED lights. But we don't have anything like that in Vanguard. For me, it was almost like jumping back on a bicycle after not riding one for a couple of years. You don't forget how to ride one. It just takes you a second to get your bearings and then you're on your way. That's what I feel in regard to what I experienced through the beta. It wasn't too bad. It wasn't crazy. Plus, this gives people an opportunity to use the characters they love. And of course, I'm sure this ties hand in hand with bundles and stuff that are going to be available in the store. It makes sense to always play as your favorite character, always have access to that outfit that you purchase. So yeah, I can see it going that way as well. But this also ties hand in hand with the new weapon favorites system. So for the first time in Call of Duty, if you're playing as a specific operator, you can actually use a specific weapon that they love to earn more XP. So for example, if you're using Polina Petrova, we know that she's a sniper and we know that she loves the 3-line rifle. Using that while also using that character, you will get additional XP. Now, while it probably won't be a ridiculous amount, it's still pretty cool that they're doing something like this nonetheless, especially if it's in terms of weapon XP, because then you got like 70 levels you have to go through for a lot of these weapons. I'm sure as time goes on and more operators are added through the year, as they go down the line, more and more favorites will be added. So your favorite weapon will eventually be tied to an operator in some way, shape, or form, and you can earn extra XP that way. I'm hoping this also counts towards player XP and not just weapon XP though, because it would be really nice to have that additional bonus. So at launch, the game is going to have 12 different operators. Each operator is from a different walk of life, and each one's going to have their own favorite weapon that will allow you to get that additional XP. So very cool. Through this reveal today, we also learned that out of the 20 maps that are going to be coming at launch, two of them we know now as remakes, but not from Call of Duty World War II. No, they went all the way back to 2008 with the release of Call of Duty World at War, a Treyarch title. They're bringing back two of the most iconic maps, the first one being Castle and the second one being Dome. Now, unfortunately, we don't have much gameplay of either one of these maps, but they were teased very, very briefly. Like, take a look at what they did to Castle. Like, look at how beautiful this map looks. Considering this was pulled out of 2008 and we've never seen a remake of Castle, it's incredible. Dome is going to just be the shipment of this game. I can already see it now. And if you put on the Blitz combat pacing and they have a 24/7 playlist of Dome, my gosh, it's going to be incredible. Another thing that was officially confirmed today, by the way, is the Riot Shields will in fact be returning in addition to two melee options, the standard issue knife and the ability to bayonet charge with weapons that can equip an under-barrel blade. It's really, really nice to have all these different options to play exactly how we want to play. I'm just curious how it's all going to work together in the void, right? Like, once everyone unlocks everything the game has to offer, what is it going to look like then? Obviously, there's like a honeymoon stage in the beginning where everyone just has the same type of equipment, same type of attachments, but as time goes on, cheaper and cheaper things seem to come out and it's like, damn, that's overpowered, or damn, I don't want to go up against this anymore. So I'm really curious with how many options we have, if it's going to be completely overwhelmingly annoying or just completely overwhelmingly awesome. I am, once again, cautiously optimistic about everything that we've been shown. Optimistic because it's the most content we are going to be getting at the launch of a Call of Duty game probably ever. I mean, thinking back to even a decade ago when I was playing MW2 and MW3 and the original Black Ops, I think that this is the most content we are going to be getting ever at launch for a Call of Duty game in terms of weapons, which I believe during the stream they said about 30 at launch, 16 regular 6v6 maps, of course, Champion Hill introducing another 4 maps, so that's 20 maps at launch. Upwards and sometimes over 70 attachments for weapons in this game. And of course, we have player progression and operator progression and battle pass progression and free content updates. And there's a lot, man. There is a lot going on. I'm just very, very excited to see what this game is going to look like in the long term versus what we got at launch. And the craziest part about everything that we've discussed over the past day or so with this reveal, that's just the tip of the iceberg. Like, we don't even know about the remaining multiplayer maps. We know nothing about zombies as of right now, other than Treyarch's the one really controlling the boat on that one. Like, they're taking the reins full force. We don't know anything else other than it's going to be a prologue. We got a small glimpse today of the new Warzone experience, which I was very, very happy to see. Pleasantly surprised, in fact. And one more thing. FOV Slider will 100% be coming to console at launch. What does this mean for Warzone? We don't know. What does this mean for zombies? We don't know, because right here it says multiplayer only. So I'm not entirely sure what to make of that specific announcement there. But there's just so much to see and so much to do. I'm excited and I'm kind of feeling overwhelmed when it comes to where to begin. Let me know your thoughts about it in the comment section below. I really appreciate you guys coming out to this video here today. If you enjoyed, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. All right, folks, I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.